Hello everyone, CyberZilla here. In today's video we are going to debug C programs with GDB focusing on pointers. We are going to examine our binary with some simple GDB commands and analyze them one by one. The idea of pointers is used in C. Since the physical memory cannot actually be moved, the information in it must be copied. It can be very computationally expensive to copy large chunks of memory to be used by different functions or in different places. This is also expensive from a memory standpoint, since space for the new destination copy must be saved or allocated before the source can be copied. Pointers are the solution to this problem. Instead of copying a large block of memory, it is much simpler to pass around the address of the beginning of that block of memory. Pointers are defined by prepending an asterisk to the variable name, just like here. The pointer.c program is an example of a pointer being used with a char data type, which is only 1 byte in size. As the comments in the code indicate, the first pointer is set at the beginning of the character array. When the character array is referenced like this, it is actually a pointer itself. The second pointer is set to the first pointer's address plus 2, and then some things are printed. So let's see what this program does after we execute it. Let's go to our terminal and write gcc flag g flag o pointer.c. After we execute it, we have said that the g flag includes extra debugging information. And now let's take a look at this with the GDB. GDB flag q pointer. Now let's list the source code, and this is not the old one, so this is all the code. And now we will set a breakpoint on the 10th line of the source code, or on the 11th one, sorry. This will stop the program after the hello world string has been copied into the CTRA buffer, and the pointer variable is set at the beginning of it. So we break 11 and run the program. Let's set the flavor to Intel, disassembly flavor Intel, so it's much more readable, and let's disassemble main. Now we see the RIP register. The RIP register is a pointer that points to the current instruction during a program execution by containing its memory address. Now, if we examine the variable pointer string, we will see that it has hello world. When the pointer is examined as a string, it's apparent that the given string is there and is locating at this memory address. Remember that the string itself isn't stored in the pointer variable, only in the memory address is stored there. In order to see the actual data stored in the pointer variable, we must use the address of operator. The address of operator is a unary operator, which simply means it operates on a single argument. When it's used, the address of that variable is returned instead of the variable itself. Now, if we examine the variable pointer with the address of operator, we will see that it will print the address of the pointer. It will print this one right here. When the address of operator is used, the pointer variable is shown to be located at this address in memory, and it contains this address. Now, if we print the address of operator pointer, it will print the address it's pointing to. And if we print pointer, it will print us the string and the address. The address of operator is used in conjunction with pointers, since pointers contain memory addresses. Now we have the address of .c program that demonstrates the address of operator being used to put the address of an integer variable into a pointer. The program itself doesn't output actually anything, but you can probably guess what happens even before debugging it with GDB. But let's debug it. Let's quit our current program and use gcc again .g address. Did I write that good? Yeah. address.c, and now let's gdb.qa.out. That's a default. Let's list the source code. Now we will set a breakpoint at line 8, and we will execute the program in the debugger. At this point, the majority of the program will be executed. So let's break 8 and run the program. And now let's print the int.var. This is the variable that we initialized in the beginning, and it gets the value of 5. So this command prints the value of the int.var. But now if we print this print command, so its address using the address of operator. And if we use ptr and print the address of int ptr, these next two print commands show that the int ptr contains the address of int var, and we also show the address of the int ptr for just good measure. An additional unary operator called the dereference operator exists for use with pointer. This operator will return the data found in the address the pointer is pointing to, instead of the address itself. It takes the form of an asterisk in front of the variable name, similar to the declaration of a pointer. So put it in simple words, it can retrieve the integer value to it points to. So if we print int ptr, we will get the value 5. So that was for our video today, and if you have any questions, I will be glad to answer them all. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a beautiful day.